Thank you all so very much. What a tremendous turnout. I know when I turned the corner up here and saw cars almost a mile away that this was going to be a great day for Texas and a great day for Austin. Lippy and I are very glad to be here with you. And though I think everybody is past ready to start, we still got a few people lined up out there. I'm going to kind of jump the gun, as our great state senator said, and talk to you a little early because I'm going on from here to another county convention in Hays County and another convention in Bastrop County, and then I'm going down to see all the Democratic women in Caldwell County because we got a lot more Democrats than we've ever had before. Y'all just have a seat here because I want to talk to you a little bit before I get on the road to talk about the future of our country. I support him knowing that some of my best successes have been converted through incompetence to failure. $3 trillion this administration has added to our national debt and still climbing. President Bush has poured more money from foreign sources than all of the presidents in American history before him. It's both failure and success that bring all of us here today. And the way to respond to the challenges now before us will determine whether in this fight year we achieve in this country a great success or we permit our giant failures of the past 8 years. The failures of the Bush administration we know all too well. The grand-old invasion in Iraq, the worst foreign policy blunder in American history, cost us $3 billion every week. Think about it just a little bit. Since last Sunday, we have spent $3 billion in Iraq. It's the amount of money that we could have spent to provide 1 year of college education for almost 1.2 million students. On the dean's list, not on the casualty list. And because Iraq costs $3 billion every week, next week, April Fool's Week, and the week after that, in those 2 weeks, we will have spent as much money in Iraq as the entire budget for the National Institute for Cancer. Think about it again. We could be saving lives instead of losing lives. And the deaths in Iraq, 4,000 plus American fatalities. Tens of thousands of more veterans who come home requiring care from their families and from the American taxpayer for the rest of their lives. And countless innocent civilians whose lives have been torn asunder in Iraq. And the result of this continuing disaster? Well, we have a less secure world for every American family for many decades to come. Of course, for 8 years, we've also had the Republican energy policy, a policy of, by, and for Mr. Exxon. You pay for it every time you go to the pump. Gas was $1.46, $1.46 when George Bush was inaugurated. And still, this administration is obstructing our efforts to promote renewable energy, blocking not only a good energy policy, but a job promoter right here in Central Texas with green jobs and green technology. And yes, on health care, As our great Travis County legislative delegation, Senator Watson, and all of our state representatives know so well, the Republicans have been very concerned about health care in Austin and in Washington. They have one big concern. They're afraid that we Democrats want to insure too many children and end the disgrace of Texas having a higher proportion of its children without access to health care than any other nation in our union. For many of the 47 million Americans who have no health insurance, it's a matter of life and death. One expert recently pointed out that a woman who's diagnosed with breast cancer and has no insurance has a 40% greater chance of dying than one with insurance. And for the economy, Republicans have remained in a state of denial about the recession that their ill-conceived policies have produced. The failures we've seen in the market are not inevitable. They're a result of the same lax attitude. Food for your pet without worrying whether it's safe. Because this administration doesn't think the laws apply to some people. And when those people make risky gambles and fail, they expect all of us to go bail them out. But it's not only our failures of the past, but of our success that bring us together today. Texans have spoken out in truly historic numbers, and we've had enough. The voting in our primary, the spectacular turnout in our caucuses across this county are tremendous. And I want to pay special tribute to a leadership that has been unselfish and remarkable accomplishments for our county party. Let's also Chair Chris Elliott. Chris, thank you. And let's say at the same time, Claus, ready to join in building on Chris's achievements with the support and leadership of a great new county chair, Andy Brown. Andy, thank you. You know, I see signs for both of the exceptional candidates that we have for President of the United States. And I believe that the election of either Senator Obama or Senator Clinton would be perfect. I can tell you personally, I'm mighty proud of the candidate that I'm supporting, Senator Barack Obama. We must join to empower a new president to undertake action that we need to overcome some immense obstacles. And we need to maintain the type of energy we saw at those caucuses that we see here today. And we need a citizenry that says we're not going to take no for an answer until we get these groups home, until our families have health care, our seniors have retirement security, and our students can get all the education they're willing to work for. We're not going to get the progress that we so desperately need here at home in Texas unless we're together, Clinton delegates and Obama delegates and everybody else, because we've got to secure a House of Representatives down in our state capitol that has a Democratic majority and ends the dictatorship.
Yay!
And you know, someday, I think we're maybe going to end the public embarrassment named Rick Perry. concerned about our being together today. I've received more than a few overheated emails. I'm going to read a couple of them to you. They're typical. This is from an Obama supporter. If Clinton is allowed to take this election with super Clinton delegates, my husband and I will both vote for John McCain. And a Clinton supporter wrote, I can't vote for Obama. And everybody I know says the same. I'm going to vote Republican for the first time in 30 years. That's the kind of short-sightedness that is a formula for failure. While there's been considerable attention on the problems John McCain has with the ultra-right, some polls in this country show that a Huckabee supporter is more likely to back McCain than a Clinton supporter to back Obama or an Obama supporter to support Clinton. We will either get to the Huff together, the White House together, or we'll not get there at all. And what I believe each of us needs to do Thank you so much. You know, we look forward to this fall election, and when November and October come along, we can't be saying, where's old Janie who volunteered down at the headquarters there? Where's dependable Dave who organized his precinct for Hillary? Or what happened to Anna who got everybody in her neighborhood out for Barack? We just don't have time to send out a search party for a single person that's here today. We can't put your face on a milk carton as some missing in action Democrat. We got to have you there. After all their failures, these Republicans can't win this election in November. But I tell you, if we're not together, we can lose it faster than you can say Karl Rove's dream come true. Next to you for the other candidate is the person without whom we cannot secure victory in November. I tell you what, instead of those emails, what we need is a little bit more of the spirit that a staff member of mine out in South Austin saw in her neighborhood list service just after the precinct convention. There was this posting. Me, Democrat jacket Obama supporter. You, leather coat, blonde hair delegate for Hillary. Want to get together for coffee? You know, I know not all these caucuses went smoothly. And some of it was more people than we ever thought was possible. And some of it was poor planning. And that same listserv that had that posting pointed out how confusing things were, because there was one fellow that posted and noticed on there that in the confusion of the caucus, he lost his dentures. Well, I hope that here today, if it hasn't happened already, that denim jacketed Obama supporter and that Hillary delegate have had coffee and our friends been reunited with his dentures. But most of all, I hope we can agree to disagree agreeably, and that every one of you will take the pledge that I'm taking. If I don't get my first preference for president, my first preference will be the Democratic nominee.